I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who in the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who was spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord Jesus calls, blessed those who listen to his word and put it into practice. Let us pray to the Father that we may not be just listeners, but doers of the word. Lord, let your word grow in us.
Lord, let your word grow in us. That we may have recourse to God's word in order to be trained in holiness and be equipped for every good work, we pray.
Lord, let your word grow in us.
That the word of God may permeate the culture of communication and that media practitioners may help spread the value of truth, justice, peace, and love, we pray.
Lord, let your word grow in us.
That those in public service may derive strength and inspiration from the word of God and follow the example of Christ in serving the people, we pray.
Lord, let your word grow in us.
That those who are severely tried by suffering and anxiety, those who are tempted by the values of the world, and those who grow cold in faith, may hold on God's word for courage and consolation, we pray.
Lord, let your word grow in us.
That we may joyfully serve the Lord and our brothers and sisters in ordinary circumstances, we pray.
Lord, let your word grow in us.
Almighty Father, hear our supplication. Do not allow us to be overwhelmed by confusion, doubt, and discord, but fill us with faith and courage in Jesus, your Son, and our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you.
heaven that our sacrifice be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of His name, for the good and the good of His Holy Church.
Look upon the offerings of the Church, O Lord, as she makes her prayer to you, and grant that when consumed by those who believe, they may bring ever greater holiness. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God. For you lay the foundations of the world and have arranged the changing of times and seasons. You form man in your own image and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder to rule in your name over all you have made and forever praise you in your mighty works. Through Christ our Lord. And so, with all the angels, we praise you. As in joyful celebration, we acclaim. Disciples, saying, take this all of you and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving things that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you humbly. We pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring into the fullness of charity together with Francis, Benaventura, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that we, the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may we merit to be co-heirs and alive, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honors is yours forever and ever. That we might think, judge, and act on the light of our faith in Jesus Christ. Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Please all kneel. Prayer against the death penalty. Father, source and giver of life, we lift our hearts and voices to you. Help us to build a society that truly chooses life in all situations. Let our response be, Lord, heal our pain. For those experiencing pain and anguish because of violence and crime, response. For perpetrators and victims of atrocities who both struggle with anger and hatred, response. For our broken world and chained by the desire for events, response. For our wounded society misled by illusion that one must take life in order to defend it, response. Let us say together, help us to make peace. For our country tempted to accept violence, revenge, response. For the conviction to recognize and uphold the dignity of all people, response. For the wisdom to see poverty, injustice, and lack of educational and employment opportunities as likely causes of criminality, response. For guidance and compassion in addressing the fact of both victims and perpetrators of wrongdoing, response. For the fortitude to find solutions that protect the dignity of all people and bring about true reconciliation, response. For the inspiration to renew society on the basis of love and restorative justice, response. Let us pray, Father of compassion, you let your rain fall on the just and the unjust. Give us a heart like yours, so that we may love as you love, even those who have caused us pain. There is in our land a cry for vengeance and a move to fill up death rows and kill offenders, but disguised as a call for justice. Let true and lasting justice spring forth. Jesus, our Father, you suffered execution in the hands of the powerful, but you did not let hatred overcome you. Help us to reach out to victims of violence so that our enduring love may help heal their wounds. Holy Spirit, Lord and Giver of life, to strengthen us to the struggle for justice. Help us to work tirelessly against state-sanctioned death and to renew society in truth, justice, love and respect, so that violence will cease and peace may prevail. Amen. O Mary, Mother of Life, protect the people, Filipino people from the forces of death. San Lorenzo Ruiz, San Pedro Calizon, St. Paul the First Hermit, St. Martin de Porres, Patron of the Sick. Amen.
Having consumed these gifts, we pray, O Lord, that by our participation in this mystery, its saving effects upon us may grow. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and ask for God's blessing. The hearts of your faithful submitted to your name. Entreat your help, O Lord, and since without you, they can do nothing, that is just. Grant by your abundant mercy that they may both know what is right and receive all that they need for their good. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Almighty God bless you all, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go with the love and mercy of our God.
Thanks be to God.